I know that you have specific things that you're going to share with us that you have learned from and discovered about men in all of your mini man panels and all of your interactions and all of these classes you've taught and everything. And I just think this is a really great opportunity for us to hear your perspective on some of those things.
Thank you. And I pick things that really matter to me. I didn't try and fit them into a dating or a marriage or anything like that type of category. I just, some will serve you and some will be hopefully touching your heart. So one of the first things, from more of a practical standpoint, is how men commit differently than women. You know, one of the things that we often hear in our culture is that men are non-committal and that they take forever to commit and we're ready and they're not and we can't move in with them because then there's the whole cow milk scenario and, you know, all the things that we know culturally and in our society to be the truth about men. But what I've learned over all of these years is that men commit and they commit really deeply and they commit differently than women. So if you were to ask most men, just a man on the street, hey, if you're single, would you ever want to be married? His answer will be most likely something like, if he's an, you know, older than 19, his answer will most likely be, sure, if I meet the right woman, or sure, if I meet the right person, mm-hmm. or I hope I find the right person. So they're looking at partnering from if I meet the right person. You ask a woman who's never been married, do you want to get married? Mostly the answer is yes. There are some no's, but mostly we're yes, 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 yes. And if we're a particular age, yes, yesterday. So we want marriage as a knee-jerk response, as a biological knee-jerk response of that safety and that connection and partnership, where a man is only going to do it if it's an enhancement to his life. It's not as life-threatening to a man. It's more out of a human spirit place than a biological human-animal space. And how they commit is very, very different than a woman, because if a woman is going to go on a date and she hopes that he's the one, she might even say to a girlfriend, oh, he sounds so great and his profile is amazing. I hope he's the one. Before she ever meets him, where a man is going to be much more likely to say that she could become the one after he's already met her and spent time with her. Mm-hmm. Men usually don't say, "I hope she's the one," before they ever meet. That's more of a woman thing. So they're very focused on what they need and what that whole person is, versus the title or the form of a relationship. We love the form. We love having a boyfriend and moving him into fiance and then moving him up to husband, right? We like the form of it. We want to lock that thing in. We want to be married. And women, one of the very unlovely parts of us is, and again, we don't all do this and we don't mean to do this, but we staticize each other around, ooh, hey, what does that ring mean on your finger? Are you getting the upgrade? Are you getting married? Mm-hmm. where men just don't have that relationship. So their relationship to commitment is to the whole person, and only if it makes sense, and only if it's going to elevate his life, and only if he's going to be able to get what he needs from her. And he'll take a lot longer to commit because he's going to see her on the first date and think, oh, cute and charming. And that's the beginning of filling in the puzzle pieces to the puzzle. Are we a match? Is this a future? And he'll do a lot. He'll fill out that whole puzzle before he'll commit. He'll work out every detail and see, you know, there's about 12 different things that a man will look at to see if she's the right person to marry. And he'll sort through all those things over how long it'll take him before he'll commit or even commit to boyfriend. Where a woman, and not all women, but many of us, will commit to a man even if there are things that we need to change about him. We like him. We love him. He's hot and he's funny and we like him for our life. And there are these three changes we're going to get right to work on. Do you know what I mean, Michelle?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, yes. The three things we're going to get right to work on. The fixer-upper projects begin.
Yeah, the training that we need to do, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the refining. The refining.
Yeah.
He'd be just right if.
Yeah. And they commit mm-hmm. to the whole package, you know, if you're at a family barbecue and Uncle Larry is ribbing him in the ribs with his elbow going, ah, can you believe her? Look at her over there. She's laughing so loud. And he'll say, well, yes, of course, that's just Sally. Like, he commits to the whole package. He doesn't try and change any part of it the way we do. Now, I know I'm generalizing like crazy, so all men are different, all women are different. But as a whole, it's one of the reasons why it takes men longer to commit. Also, another reason it takes them longer is because they understand there's a huge difference between I'm dating you and I'm now your boyfriend. And then again, when I'm your boyfriend versus I'm your husband. Because they are acutely aware that when they get upgraded to the new status, there's a whole lot of accountabilities that come with that. Like, you own them. You own their time. You make a honey-do list. You tell him how to dress, some of you. You tell him who he can hang out with and who he can never hang out with again ever. You're going to make him go to Utah at Christmas. Sorry, Michelle. You're going to make him go to Utah at Christmas, even though he hates the snow and some of your crazy family members. You own him. Right? So part of the checking you out is this the person that I'm going to let own me, and is she going to give me freedom and space in some of these areas, or is she going to be the person who's just running the show and in charge? I'm going to bullet point it for you, and you all are just going to have to road test it to see yourself if it's true. I'm going to say it. I'm going to tell you you should believe it, and if you don't believe it, go check this out for yourself. Men do not see our stretch marks. Single focus has them focus on our beauty. And if you think that you have a flaw that is not a part of your beauty, if he's noticing your stretch marks, it's because he thinks it's beautiful. They only focus on what's beautiful. They don't see anything else. I didn't believe it for the longest time. Go check it out. There are my thoughts.
Well, I love that, Wendy. And I'm just going to say this really quickly. So most of you know that I'm a breast cancer survivor, and I have everything that that entails. I went mm-hmm. through chemo, a double mastectomy, radiation, the whole works. And what I can tell you is that I don't have the same body that I had before then. I have some scars, and I have some owies, and my hair has grown back, fortunately. But one of my fears, along with surviving cancer, was would my husband still find me attractive? And I can tell you that one of the most moving things that happened to me during the breast cancer journey, if there was a gift in that, was when my husband would kiss my bald head and tell me how beautiful I was and how I still know that he still sees me as beautiful despite the fact that I now have rebuilt breasts and I'm not the same as I was before, but he doesn't see me that way. He sees me as who I am. He sees me for the essence of who I am, for my beauty, and for all that I am, and not just those physical things. And I think that it is really important to say this because there's this perception that men see our flaws in the same way that we see our flaws. But I think it comes back to what we were talking about earlier, Wendy. If we're his type, if we're his woman, he's going to continue to see us as beautiful, and he's
Absolutely.
Going to see the beautiful things in us. So I just want to say, yep, that one's true.